Why are they saying I'm sending too much spam? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. I've just received the message that my response to an email from a friend could not get delivered because there is too much spam coming from that IP. The IP given is not my IP. Mine is totally different according to what I saw on the link you posted some time ago. What's going on? How can I be punished for something I did not do? I have never sent spam to anyone. Correct. You are likely being punished for the actions of others. And exactly how that happens and exactly why that IP address doesn't match what you see on your machine is something we need to explain. It's important to understand that when you send an email, the email goes from your machine to your email service provider's server, from their server to the email service provider of your recipient, and then finally from that email service provider, it eventually makes its way to your recipient's email. But notice that, yes, you are sending to your email service provider, but so is everybody else. What that means is that the IP address that was probably in that email you got is likely to be the IP address of your email service provider, not you. When a spammer shows up and they start using an email service that happens to be the same one you're using, it negatively affects the reputation of that email service, which is one of the reasons that email services are so hard on spam. When you think about it, your email just gets bundled into a bunch of other email coming from your email provider, your email service, and all of that gets sent on to the recipient's email service. And if it sees 1,000 emails coming in and 999 of them are spam, that means that your email service isn't doing a good job of preventing spam from being sent. Therefore, that other email provider, the one you're trying to send email to, you're the one out of 1,000 that's not spam, they may just say, you know what? We can't take any email from this service because they've proven that they're not able to manage their spam. That's what we so often mean about the reputation of an email sender. Depending on the email that they send out, their reputation can be good, because they don't forward on much spam, or it can be bad, because they do. And you, in this case, are paying the price for that. Now, the obvious case, of course, is when a spammer is literally using your email service to send spam. But there are other approaches. That particular scenario is usually pretty quickly detected and shut down. It could be, instead, the account of an innocent, legitimate customer that's been hacked and is being used to send spam. It could be the PC of a legitimate, innocent customer that has been infected with malware that has made it a part of a zombie botnet. Sometimes those two will get routed through your email service provider, depending on the characteristics of the bot and the botnet. Again, probably wasn't you. I believe you when you say that you're not sending spam. Honestly, most people don't. But because spam is such a problem, it is something that the email services have to keep as tight a lid on as they possibly can without too much collateral damage. In this case, yep, you're the collateral damage. What do you do? Certainly, you can change email providers, but that's not always a pragmatic answer. For this specific situation, if you've got one specific person that you're trying to reach and you're getting this message, fire up another email account at another service. If you're seeing all this on Yahoo, set up a Gmail account. If you're seeing this on Outlook.com, set up a Yahoo.com. You get the idea. Set up a different free email account so that you're not using the same email service to send your message, and hopefully, that will get through. For updates, for comments, for links related to the topic and more, visit askleo.com/15427. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.